This is our world, a bright blue-green globe of life that shines by the reflected light of its parent star, our sun. Our world, but it is not yet the wonderful world that it can be. As a species, we have proven ourselves through the centuries of being capable of the most shocking cruelties and hatreds against our kind and against that great number of other lives with whom we share this fragile planet. Our violence, our aggression, our blooding of the world has done great harm to ourselves and to so many, many others who have felt the blow of the dark hand of humanity. But it does not have to be so. We are capable of great passions. Our emotions stir within us and rouse us to great thoughts and deeds. We can open our hearts, minds, and souls to wisdom and compassion. We can, in wonder, regard the billions who are our fellow travelers on this world through space and time. And we can, if we want, let love be the light of our lives. We can open our eyes in a new dawn onto the best of all possible worlds, if, and it's a big if, we dare to believe in love in its most perfect form, and we dare to be love expressed completely and absolutely, without compromise or hesitation, without condition, limitation, or mitigation. Love given to all, deservedly and unreservedly. Love, the great equalizer, creating a world, finally, where equality for all is the refining emotion of our life. And in this world, we will learn to know what equality for all lives really means. It means that we will know, as I know now, that I am the equal of every other life in this world, and they are the equal of me. It means that I know that as I am worthy of my life, so too every one of these others is equally worthy of their lives. We each have life, and our lives are equal, each to each, equally one another, deserving of our every breath and our share in the space and time of our lives, our days and our nights beneath the sun and the moon, the great arc of the cosmic light. It means that I know that I am exactly the equal of the rat who runs through the forest, and he is absolutely, totally the equal of me. And I am the same, the equal of the chicken that picks and pecks at the ground below her feet, and she is truly, eye to eye, the same, the equal of me. It means that I am the same as the cod that darts this way and that through the dark, cold waters of the northern seas, and he is the same as me. He is worthy of his life, the beating of his heart, just as I am worthy of the beating of my heart. We are brothers beneath our skin, equal and the same in the beating of our hearts. It means that I am equal to, precisely equal to, the cow and the pig and the sheep, not better than them, and they are not worse than me. We are the same, the lamb and I, the piglet and I, the calf and I. All of us the same, of one substance born, the stuff of stars, and all warmed by the one light of our one sun. We are one. I am the lion and the wolf and the horse, the bear, the eagle, and the gorilla, and they are me. And so too is the mouse, the crab, and the scorpion, the lizard, the toad, and the squid, together with the octopus, the shark, and the whale, and the seal, and the walrus, the lobster, and the turkey. It makes no difference to me, because they are no different to me. Whether they creep, swim, or fly, we are all the same beneath the blue of the sky. All of us children of our Mother Earth, all of us equal in her maternal eye. This is the meaning of perfect love, that we are all of us, every life on earth, equally as worthy as one another, equally deserving of the life we have, the breath we take, the freedom we crave, the safety we covet, the comfort we wish for, the love we desire. When we aspire to be the equal of every other, we reach the height of perfection, express the finest intention, and convey the wisest reflection of our role, our place, our space in the fabric of the world and the cosmos. The meaning of our life is given when the love that we have is offered, always and every time, to every life, and every moment of our life is taken as a chance to love.